What's up, Monticello? Time for another edition of MHS Student News. I'm Robin Robdog Hickman.
And I'm Avery Haig. And let's get to the news. First up, a sports update. Wrestling, girls basketball, gymnastics, and hockey teams have concluded their seasons.
If you haven't heard, the boys basketball team won a giant upset against Delano last Friday, so they're headed to their state match today, March 31st.
Wish them the best of luck as they play the 20-1 Alexandria Cardinals. The game will be played at St. Cloud Tech High School.
We also want to highlight that a Monticello gymnast, Presley Pearson, recently participated in the state gymnast meet. Nice job, Presley.
Last thing about your sports, spring seasons are starting, so sign up if you haven't. You can find sign-up information on Infinite Campus.
It's time for a new episode of Bryce's Block Talk, this time with the special guests, Gavin Brooks and Mason Bowmaster.
Hey guys, it's Gavin.
It's Mason.
And it's Bryce. We're back with another episode of Block Talk. I'm here with Mason and Gavin. They're going to ask me a couple questions as I build this time lapse.
Okay, Bryce. So what set is this?
This is set number 71295.
Next question. Where'd you get it?
I got this at Target. Well, originally I got it as a birthday gift, but it retails for $30 at Target, which is overpriced for the set.
How long would you say this took you to make?
It took precisely about 20 minutes in real time. I did this during a stream last Sunday with some of my Lego buddies.
Okay, thank you.
You are welcome. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Bryce, for that segment. Here's an announcement from the main office. The student body has over $18,000 in class fees and fines.
In dollars. We ask that everyone take a look at their outstanding course fees and speak with their teachers about how they can get those fees removed.
Now we have another episode of Catty Maddie's Crazy Cat Corner.
Another episode of Catty Maddie's Crazy Cat Corner, and as always, I have my assistant here, Gavin. And on today's episode, we have another segment of Cat TikTok Dances March Madness Edition. Last week, our winner was Leo. Don't forget to vote again. I'll be just saying, now stop and let your homeboy hit it. Beat it. I think I'm falling in love. She said, what you know about love? I tell you everything. I got what you need. Woke up in the store and get what you want. Go get. You get what you please. We about to get it on.
That wasn't supposed to happen. If this is you, and you need some help getting better at games, or just looking for some friends to play games, the Monticello Gaming Team is for you. Let me explain. So, there's going to be three different parts to the Monticello Gaming Team. To start off, we just have casual video games, which is stuff like Rocket League, Minecraft servers, Valheim servers, just stuff that we can play together that isn't too competitive and there's no stakes involved. Next, we would have tabletop games, which include stuff like chess, checkers, other stuff like that, and card games involved too, like Magic the Gathering, Pokemon, etc. And finally, we have the esports portion, which I sort of manage around here. And with that, we're going to be playing in the Minnesota Varsity League starting either next year or even this summer if possible. So delving into the esports portion a bit more, I'm going to be leading it myself this year, and the main goal is going to be find a leader for next year. The games that we're going to be starting with are probably going to be just Rocket League and Minecraft Bed Wars, but there is options to get into either Call of Duty, Super Smash Bros., and even chess if we wanted to. We're not going to be doing tryouts this year necessarily just because of the fact that their spring season already has started, but there may be summer options and fall options.
Are online games too stressful for you, or do you just not enjoy them? Well, we have a solution. Here at the Monticello Games Club, name pending, we have three different categories of games. There's the tabletop, the online games, and what I'm here to talk about is the card games. Card games include games like Magic the Gathering, Yu-Gi-Oh!, and Pokemon. Whether you're new to card games or a seasoned veteran, we offer any and all students an invite to come to Mr. Swart's room next Tuesday after school for information on the Monticello Games Club.
Our first meeting for the Monticello Gaming Club will be next Tuesday, April 6th, up in Mr. Swart's room. If you don't know where that is upstairs in the English pod, and he happens to be the one of the first doors right on your right. You'll see the big sign saying Mr. Swart. Now, don't worry, this first meeting will only take about 30 to 45 minutes. We'll be signing everyone up, getting everything set up. It'll be an informational meeting, so missing it isn't a super big problem. You can email me if you have any questions at this email below, and if you miss the meeting, just make sure you sign up with this link. Be forewarned though, we will not be supplying supplies for specific things. Like in tabletop games, we won't be supplying the books. That will either have to be found online or you'll have to bring your own. And for gaming, we will not be bringing extra computers for you to use. It will be assumed that you have some kind of computer at home or that you are able to play on some kind of console at the school or play at home. Now, when it comes to Magic and card games, Mr. Swart does have extra cards, so you shouldn't need to worry about bringing your own deck, although it is highly recommended you do. And what if you want to show up to these meets, but you don't actually have anything? You're not specifically interested in a tabletop RPG or not interested in being in an esports. You just like games. You like talking to people that like playing games, and you just generally are that kind of person. Well, don't worry. Come by and stop. Hang out with us. We will be open for everyone to come by, stop, and hang out. You don't need to play games. You don't need to be forced to do anything. If you want to hang out with us and talk with us, feel free to do it. It is open for you to do.
If you want more information on the gaming club, make sure to contact Austin Ray through his email.
Like every year, we are making the senior slideshow featuring the seniors that we all know and love. Parents should submit a kindergarten or preschool era photo of their senior to the following email.
Make sure to get those in soon. Now we have a regularly scheduled, totally consistent episode of News of the Weird. Roll it.
Good morning, Monticello. Welcome to another episode of News of the Weird. I'm your host, Matthew. Now let's get on with the news.
First up, Googers. We all know them. This man has a Ring doorbell. That Ring doorbell captured four of them outside of his basement door. Four Googers, all like this one. You can't see my hand, but know I'm doing a hand gesture. Googers.
Googers.
Not Florida man, California man. This California man hid in an airport for three entire months, authorities say. Allegedly, he was hiding because he was scared to travel due to COVID-19. He was caught with a manager's security badge after asked for identification and currently faces felony trespassing charges. Wacky. Anyways, thanks for watching this episode of News of the Weird. Remember, Monticello, stay weird!
In other news, Minnesota will be opening up to the vaccine to those 16 and older as of March 31st.
Dang, that's cool. If you fit this criteria, get signed up online and find a vaccination spot near you.
That's all for this episode of MHS Student News. See ya.
Bye.